I'll be performing tonight at the Jazz Cafe.
All right, y'all. Have a good time.
I'm gonna touch on some cover songs. I'm gonna get into some James Brown.
Big payback. How y'all doing?
Basically, just it's the Angie Stone party.
One, 2, 3.
I want people to be familiarized because a lot of people don't know me yet. But hopefully tonight they'll understand where I came from, what energy level I'm at, because to recap soul, soul is to understand it. First, let me tell you the name of the album is Black Diamond and where it came from. My daughter, whose name is Diamond, I didn't have to think real hard about this album. I just did it. Every album before that, I've had to basically structure a song and sit down and shape it and fix it so that it fits into society. And this time, I just didn't care. It's just like, you know what? What you're hearing is what you're getting.
More than life and living, I want you to come into my heart.
My sound is a product of voices of old generations. I have a raspy voice, and I think that has come from over the years of just singing and wear and tear. When I think of who I sound like, I can sound like a lot of people sometimes because I'm influenced by a lot of people, like Gladys Knight, like Chaka Khan, you know, like Roberta Flack. When you listen to women with authoritative voices like that, I think we're all kind of we're in a leadership role because we are strong voices. Being Southern has shaped my independence as to where I'm going to end up in life in general. Musically, I won't be torn or jarred out of, you know, I found my place home now. So I'm so happy that people accept the album the way it is because this is easy for me. It's like, oh God, I can't wait to do the next record. I just did a video called No More Rain in This Cloud that was shot by Andrew Dossimo, and the video is hot. I ended up co-producing basically everything on the album. My mind was set on what I wanted to do. Didn't have time to look for producers, but 5-6 songs into the project, the company started to play my stuff. And everybody wanted to be down on it.
Broken spirit, lost and confused, empty, scared, used and abused.
Some of the people I'd always wanted to work with that really didn't give me the time of day until they heard what I was capable of.
Ain't it funny that the way you feel shows on your face,
all over your face, yeah.
And the smile you used to wear.
All these people were inspired by what they had heard, and when they came to me, they had listened to the 6 songs that I had done and tried to mimic the sound, which I thought was very clever because I wouldn't take a contemporary song. It just had to be me.
Oh, 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 hold on.
With me evolving into my own identity, I had to shed a few things. And one of the things was I wanted to get out of perming my hair because it was hell to keep my hair up on the road, always putting, I shouldn't curse D, I'm sorry. The first thing I did was change my hair because natural, and I went back to what I grew up on, which was a press and comb and braiding and braiding and braiding. And it's the most wonderful thing I've done for myself, because I get up now and I just shake my hair and I go. D'Angelo and I are like freaking frack in the industry. We work like a clock works to a shorthand. He's like a brother to me. We have an incredible amount of love and respect for each other because we're one and the same. He's me and I'm him. I think what he brought to Angie Stone was the idea of be who you are and stop trying to be commercial, because you're full of soul. And he was basically a backbone in pushing who I was hiding underneath who people knew me as, because I worked that way so closely with him on his album, and he knew what everybody else didn't know. If you keep on, you can't do nothing but win. I mean, and I hope that Black Diamond and Angie Stone is an example of perseverance makes for perfection. Just really wanted to do a record that expressed me, and I wanted to be able to go, and it's like having a gospel. It was the gospel truth. And tell it like it is. What you hear is what you get. And I think everybody who's anybody who listens to my record, somewhere in that album, you find yourself. And you don't have to wait very long. You're gonna find yourself. You're gonna end up saying, I can relate.